Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, depending on where you are in this amazing world. My name is Donovan Jolly, and welcome, everybody, to another video of DIY Investing. On this channel, we like to go over a lot of different altcoins, and oftentimes there's a lot of good altcoins that I don't get to really cover. Today, we're going to be diving into five altcoins that I think are extreme dark horse candidates for having a massive bull run in this next cycle. These coins are oftentimes a little bit underlooked, and I often think to myself that these ones are going to be good investments and would be an excellent long hold for the future of crypto. A lot of people might agree with me and a lot of people might disagree, but the point of this channel is always to just help educate and spread awareness to all of the different cryptocurrencies, no matter what they are. Remember, if you are new and just finding this channel, always remember to do myself a favor by leaving a like, comment, and subscribing to this channel. Make sure you guys click that notification bell so you don't miss out on any new videos like the one provided for you here. If you're new and just getting into crypto, one of the hardest things that you can do is oftentimes finding good quality content you can trust. Inside of my Discord server, I offer a course and signals. The course is 20 educational videos that teach you guys all of the same strategies that I use to profit inside of crypto. It's really all of the trading strategies and investment resources that I use that I actually go about making my investments when I do trade and invest in cryptocurrency. The signals are a mix of both short-term, mid-term, and long-term investment and trading setups that I'm taking. I also offer portfolio management. So if you guys are actually looking to copy what I'm doing inside of this market and this next bull cycle, I highly recommend that you guys check out my Discord. Click the invitation link in the description of this video, and there you're gonna get access to that. Once you have access, just make sure you guys message me on here and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. All right, guys, we got a lot of coins to talk about today, so let's jump right into this amazing update. So the first one on the list today is going to be Monero, or XMR. Now, this was one of the original OG cryptocurrencies from back when I first started investing. I actually had a buddy that had a significant amount of money invested into this way back in the day. And I remember this one actually from Darknet Markets, because that was predominantly where it was before it really was worth anything. That was way back here in 2016. Now, the interesting thing about XMR to me is I don't hear a whole lot about it anymore. I do know people invest in it, but for the most part, I'm actually kind of surprised you don't hear a whole lot of talk about it. Now, for me, I think that this one is a good play for this next cycle. I think you can count on it consistently because I do believe privacy tokens have a significant place and they do have an extreme use case in general. I mean, it's really important that we can keep our privacy safe and we can have anonymity when it comes to transacting. And I think that Monero actually is really helpful in that regard. And so what we're seeing in Monero is adoption taking place in like darknet sites on black market websites. And that's really something that's driven a lot of value into this. Really, Bitcoin in that last cycle saw Ethereum rise extremely well with it. Ethereum really had one of the most parabolic runs that we saw out of all of the high cap coins. And we can see that that took place right here, just a pretty parabolic trend that went straight up. Now, if you would have bought down here at these low values, it would have been over 1,000 extra turns if you would have held to the top. Now, really, this takes us to phase two in the cycle, and this is the current market cycle. And it's really the same exact setup for the most part. To me, I see the exact same kind of market cycle fractal playing out. And this is what I see in the altcoin total market cap as well. But it's interesting how it's actually reflected in each and every altcoin, because they all show different similarities. Now, what takes place, we really get added to the exchange, we make this little double bottom, fail support, and then we go into new lows. And really, this is capitulation right here. Now, this is roughly the same sort of cycle that I see here in Ethereum as well. Really, the only difference is we have a clear uptrend in this one, whereas this one we didn't. Now, the same thing can be said here. We get the same little double bottom formation, only to fail support and then drop to new lows. And that's what we saw here. Capitulation takes place. And what really takes place after that is just our first little sideways consolidation. You could say that this is the first impulse because we have made a higher high, but really it's following roughly the same sort of trend. And so for me, we're seeing a lot of volume that's came in here in this dip. This is a lot of accumulation. We have a pretty significant amount of volume here. I don't find it likely that we're going to sell off. I think the bull runs are started, and I've told you guys that. Now for me, this even follows the same sort of time frames that we've been looking for inside of the market. We get the reversal around the new year, a little bit premature, right about there. And then we can see we start the bull run at the start of the next new year. And so we even follow the same sort of cyclical analysis. 2018 was the top, and then we get the same sort of trend as well. And so we're watching this. And so we're watching this because realistically where it looks to me like we're at is roughly the same point that we were. I'm going to delete this one because it doesn't make a lot of sense. It looks like we're roughly at the exact same point that we were back in the early days when I first got into crypto. Now what's taken place is we had capitulation and we've made our first higher high. Obviously the one back in the day was a little bit more parabolic, but this one is more just sideways accumulation in my opinion. And so what we're seeing now is this new year is the seeing the reversal out of this. And so I think that we're actually going to see another clear uptrend similar to what we saw in Ethereum or in Monero in the last cycle. And so I think that buying and holding the majority of this trend is going to be very profitable. I think that this cycle mainly just started, and the fact that it looks almost identical to the last cycle, I believe that this one being a high cap coin is going to continue to see a lot of profitability. So everybody keep an eye out for Monero. Watching it in this next cycle, I'm actually going to be looking to accumulate some, probably just make a small position. But this is one of those high caps where you kind of put some money into it, and it's a safe haven asset for this next bull run, because the high caps, you can count on them to outperform the majority of the market. They're more consistent, they're less volatile, and so it's just a little bit easier to hold those and put a more concentrated amount of wealth inside of those assets. And so everybody watch out for this one. Now, next up on the list is going to be Litecoin. Litecoin, to me, is the most beautiful market cycle out of the entire altcoin market. Does it mean that I have the biggest position in it? No, it doesn't, but I do love the setup that it's showing. Now, I do have a small position. I accumulated it up a little bit higher here at about $69. And that was actually when it was first originally dipping. Now, I made a little bit of a loss, but I only have like 3.5 Litecoin, so it really wasn't a big majority. It was just a really small investment that I just bought some. But I'm actually looking at this as another really good setup, and I think that we're starting the early stages of once again just a breakout. Now, the thing about these markets is they're all going to be reflecting roughly the same sort of setups. They're all going to be showing roughly the same sort of time frames, and it's because they all grow on the same trend. And so you got to remember that when I point one altcoin, they're really all doing similar setups. But the reason I'm picking these coins specifically is just because I think a lot of people are sleeping on them. Now, the reason I think a lot of people are sleeping on Litecoin is because we did have this halving that just took place somewhere in the summer. It was up here, I remember. But then we actually sold to new lows. And this is a pretty consistent approach that happens with the halvings that I've seen inside of Bitcoin. Now, what happens in Bitcoin is after the halving, we generally see a sell-off. And then that's really where we see the bulk of our rises shortly after the halving. And so I think that we're going to see the similar approach with Litecoin. Litecoin being a altcoin, I do believe that it saw more volatility on the downside because this was about a 40, 50, potentially even 60% drop. Yeah, so 63% drop, a significant drop after this halving. And so I think that it's really cheap in consideration compared to like how high we were at $141. Now, you guys have got to remember that Litecoin was actually leading the market. Whatever Litecoin was doing, the rest of the market was following, and Litecoin actually led that bull rise that we saw with Bitcoin and Litecoin. And really, you would have made more money holding Litecoin than you would Bitcoin. And so I think that a lot of people were actually just buying the rumor of this halving, and then that's why we saw such a volatile swing on the downside. But I still think that this is an exceptional hold for the long term for that one reason. Now, what the halving is, the mining reward getting cut in half, happens every 4 years. Litecoin just had it. And so I think that this is going to see a lot more upside. We do have consistent volume coming in here. To me, this looks like just the first impulse. I still think that we could drop a little bit lower, potentially down here to about $54 approximately. But this to me looks like a little ABC correction before we just see more bullish continuation. Something along the lines of this, 1, 3, 5, ABC, and then we just kind of continue on in this trend, right? That's kind of what I'm looking for in this cycle. I think that the bull run has really started, and we're going to start seeing the bulk of the parabolic runs from here on out. Now, keep Litecoin on your radar because this is just one of those older coins, more consistent ones. And actually, Litecoin has some of the more institutional development compared to any other altcoin out there. And so, once again, we're talking about a lot of high caps in this video because it's those high caps that I don't talk about that are often going to be the best performing. And so, that's really why I call them dark horse candidates, is because I think most most people are excited about the new shiny altcoins, the ones that have just came out, the ones that you've never really heard about or haven't made cycles. And those are definitely good holds as well. But I think that a lot of concentration should be felt upon these higher cap coins as well. Now, to me, the reason why I actually liked Litecoin was because it has one of the original market cycles that you see with the older high cap coins, where it kind of makes its first impulse and it drops to new lows or fully retraces, and then it makes its first impulse. Now, this is just showing a strong market cycle, and really what came after that was just a first major impulse. And so to me, I think with this halving, we could see a pretty parabolic run. The only reason I don't have a major position in this is because the profit potentials don't seem quite as good. And so I would rather invest in other things, but I still think that this is one that will perform well, and we should keep it on our radar heading into this next cycle. Next up is going to be one that I think is probably one of the most hated coins out there. It's one of the easiest ones to talk down upon. And that is Zcash. Now, Zcash to me is one of those that's a little bit more of a gamble, obviously, because it has had such a nasty bear market. Really, what I should show you before I start this off, just so we understand the risk factor, this is the Bitcoin pair. Let's remove all drawing tools. This is the Bitcoin pair here, and we can see that it's kind of a really, really sketchy looking setup. If we drop it to a log scale, we're going to see that we've mainly just sold off a lot. And so this is kind of a scary setup, a lot more risk involved with this. So I want to point that out before we jump into this. Obviously, I'm not a paid financial advisor. You guys should never just look at the analysis and take trades off of that. That's why I have a group set up. But looking at this setup, I do like it for a couple reasons. Now, one, we did retest all previous support. We fully retraced the last cycle's move. Now, that to me just means that it's a little bit more undervalued than a lot of these. And the reason for that is that we got the impulse. Now, the impulse is setting up, and we're getting a support and resistance flip that's actually taking place here. Now, we can see that this was the previous support. We made the cycle high. Everything, well, not everything, but some altcoins failed support and made new lows when the short-term correction of Bitcoin happened, and Zcash was one of them. Now, what Zcash is just doing is it made an impulse, and it's now regaining this resistance as support. And so this is now support, in my opinion. And we need to see it hold here, obviously, but I think that this is a good setup right now. And we're going to see roughly the same thing that took place in the last cycle as well. And this is what has to take place. Anytime you're making lower lows and lower highs, the only way to reclaim and start a new trend is to actually break out, retest the previous support, retest the previous resistance as new support, and then we start the new trend. And so this is one I want everybody to keep on their radar, because we just had a major event take place as far as consolidation. This is a major bullish setup that's playing out right here, and that's really across the board in general. It doesn't matter which altcoin you're choosing at this point. They're pretty much all going to go out. They're pretty much all going to go up. And so watching Zcash here, the biggest reason I like this is because just the fact that there is a lot of profit potential. Now, this is all based off of a technical setup. I really don't know a lot about Zcash besides it's just cryptocurrency for anonymity. But I can see here that from a technical perspective, buying now and holding to the all-time high is a roughly 18x return. And so I think that this is one that is oftentimes slept on because a lot of people have kind of written it off. They've just counted as a shit coin nonetheless. But I actually think that if this holds support here and we do see a continued impulse, this one has a potential to really outperform a majority of altcoins out there and actually give you a really consistent return, it being a high cap coin that has been around for the previous cycles. Now, to me, this looks something more like the potential for a 1, a 3, and then a 5 based off of Fibonacci. I believe we're really close to that 618. Yeah, so that 618 is going to come down a little bit lower. And so I would actually even set a buy range for about here. And that's what I'd be watching, $48 to $44 approximately. That's going to be around that 618 ratio. And that also comes about support of the previous resistance. So I think that we're going to see continuation coming in majority of these altcoins. This is really just the first impulse that we're seeing take place of the new bull trend. And so really, this is the best risk to reward ratio setup that you are going to find, because this is the start of the new trend. And I could be completely wrong about that and we could fall, but spreading awareness, like I say, I think that I'm going to be proven right, but we're just going to have to see what takes place. So watch out for Zcash. All right, guys, this is one I haven't talked about a lot. I know a lot of people follow me. I know that, Maxi, you're going to actually really appreciate me talking about this because I know you've been waiting for me to talk about Digibyte for a while. So here it is. I actually hold a little bit of this one. Now, it's not a very big portion of my portfolio, but I actually like the setup that's playing out here, and I am potentially looking to add. Now, the reason I haven't bought any of this is just because of the uncertainty. Now, what's taking place in Digibyte was it got delisted from Poloniex. Poloniex doesn't really mean anything anymore, but it isn't also listed on Binance. Now, what was taking place inside of the recent correction was actually that the CEO of Digibyte was talking to, he was talking about how centralized Tron was, and then Tron had just recent, well, Justin Sun had just recently purchased Poloniex, and he actually delisted Digibyte because of that. Now, what previously took place was the fact that the CEO of Digibyte was also upset that CZ Binance had asked for so much of the supply just to list Digibyte on their exchange. I have no idea if any of that is true because I could never prove that, but that was just what was taking place. Now, from that point, we saw a sell through support, and we've really just continued on in this correction. And this is one of those coins that was a really good performer in the last cycle. It has good fundamentals from a technical, it has really good fundamentals. I mean, it's one of the faster blockchains. I actually think that this one is slept on in a big regard. Now, there is no volume at all in this, hardly at all, compared to any of the cycles. Now, obviously in a declining market, that's what you want to see. So this is technically a bearish, so this technically is a bullish volume profile. Now, when I look at this, I see just a big elongated correction. Now, where some altcoins held support here and made a higher high, other ones failed support. Now, the ones that failed support did show weakness, and I think that that could have been with a lot of uncertainty in the market. And so certain coins failed support. Now, those certain coins failing support, they could very easily continue on and go lower. Now, it would have to go really far. Now, I don't see that as the likely scenario. Maybe some of these altcoins actually do die out, but us starting this new bull run, I would assume that we're going to continue to go up. And this one being a high cap coin, performing so well in the last bull cycle, I'm not just going to write it off quite yet. Now, the way I was drawing this was about here, and I thought that we had broken out, but we actually made a new low. And so what that tells me is we started a different bearish trend. Now, I thought that the descending resistance was a little bit premature. It was actually a little bit further out. And now what's actually taken place is we've broken outside of that descending resistance. Now, this could be a fake out, similar to what I thought was happening right here, where I thought we broke out here. But I think that really what that was me drawing my trend line too premature. Because what I've seen inside of Digibyte for a while is a few different factors. I've actually really liked the setup. Now, the only real difference was we failed support, where I thought we were going to continue to go up. Now, everybody makes mistakes. That's just part of cryptocurrency. Sometimes it's volatile. Now, what I like about this setup is if we drop it to a weekly scale and we take a look, let's actually remove the RSI because there wasn't anything too important there. On the weekly MACD, we have seen bullish divergence since back at the reversal of the new year. Now, even though we made a lower low, what that's telling me is we have major, 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 major bullish divergence taking place on this RSI. And you're not going to see too many setups that are going to play out with this big of a bullish divergence on a weekly time frame. And so I'm actually looking at this one for a buying opportunity because I think that nobody's talking about this. It's been delisted from some exchanges. Well, mainly just Poloniex, but I think that this is actually setting up for a good buy. Now, if this is going to set up, we do have what the early signals I would look for a short-term reversal, and that is bullish divergence. It's not on the RSI, but it is on the MACD, and the MACD is showing a really strong one, so I'm going to trust that. Now, we've also broken from descending resistance. Remember, it could be a fake out, but with this, we are coming back into contact of that descending resistance, which theoretically should be acting as support. And so I think that if you're willing to take a little bit of a risky bet in buying this, keep in mind we have technically failed support. That's why these are my dark horse candidates. We have rejected. We are making a lower low. I think that if this was a potential for a reversal, it is going to take place now. And with us being outside of the short-term descending resistance, I'm watching that. This one's a little bit more of a risky bet. That's once again why it's a dark horse, but I think that this one should be on the radar with this massive bullish divergence that's actually playing out. Keep your eye out for Digibyte because we could very easily see a reversal very soon. Now, the last one on the list today is going to be Stellar Lumens. Now, Stellar Lumens made me a lot of money, made some people close to me a lot of money in the last bull cycle. I actually had a really awesome experience where I had a duplicated transaction that took place on an exchange, and they actually duplicated my transaction of Stellar Lumens all the way at the bottom of this. And so I actually only had like $50 on the exchange itself, and so they duplicated my transaction. I kept the money and then just left because I didn't have KYC, and so I ended up just keeping like $1,500. It was only like $1,500 worth of Stellar Lumens, but down here, $1,500 worth of Stellar Lumens turned into a lot of dollar value up here. And so that was actually a pretty cool experience I had of that in the last bull run. But this is one that made me a lot of money, and I actually haven't talked about it a whole lot on the channel. I don't know why. Now, this one is actually a sister coin to XRP. I believe that one of the creators of XRP left XRP and went to create this one. Now, this one has partnerships with IBM. I think that that is a really good catalyst just to have for that next bull run. Any sort of partnerships, especially if it's a high cap, and it's really those high caps that do have the partnerships that we're looking for. It's harder and more risky to invest in those other coins because we don't know what's going to happen with them. But Stellar Lumens has the partnership with IBM. Now, on top of that, what we recently just saw inside of this correction was actually that Stellar Lumens burned 50% of the supply. Now, previously, I don't remember how many Stellar Lumens there were, but there was a lot of Stellar, or Lumens is what they call them. Now, what happened is they burned half of that supply because they thought that that would better fulfill whatever they were trying to do as a company. Now, that to me screams bullish. I don't know if you can get a more bullish setup besides that. I mean, if they burn half the supply, how can that be bearish? And a lot of people were talking down on that. Now, what we've seen is elongated correction. From the high of the cycle, we've corrected 95%. So this was one of the biggest losers inside of the high caps. Now, with that to me, what we're seeing currently is actually we've broken from our major descending resistance that has held us throughout the entire length of this bear market correction. And we are now getting a successful retest of that as support. Now, out of all of the coins on this list, I think that this one's probably the best setup in the now. And what I'm seeing currently is just perfect across the board. We broke from the major log descending resistance. We have the potential of an inverse head and shoulder playing out. This inverse head and shoulder on the right shoulder is coming perfectly in contact with support of the left shoulder. And it's also perfectly in support with the descending resistance. Now, if you're a big XRP holder, I think that holding some Stellar might not be a bad idea. I mean, if you hold XRP, there's not really a big reason to hold Stellar. But based off of a cycle perspective, I actually think that this one's really nice because we're having almost the same consolidation. These two look exactly the same. Stellar and XRP accumulate and follow each other. Now, I actually think that they're going to both follow again, and we're going to see a breakout of the inverse head and shoulder. And that's what I updated you guys with recently on my XRP analysis. Now, this is the analysis that I had for you. I wanted to go over my five dark horse candidates. I think all of these are good, profitable setups. Keep in mind, I am not a paid financial advisor. This is your own risk, whatever you were doing with your investments. I'm just showing you guys the analysis. I'm showing you guys my five picks for the dark horse candidates moving into this next cycle. Keep these on your radar because I actually expect them to perform exceptionally well. Now, thank you guys so much for the support. Always remember, if you found value in this video, to leave a like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Click that notification bell so you don't miss out on any new videos like the one provided for you here. Remember, guys, I also offer a video course and signals. The video course is 20 educational videos that teach you guys all of the same strategies that I use to profit inside of cryptocurrency every day. And the signals are a mix of short-term, mid-term, and long-term trading and investing opportunities. You guys can also copy my portfolio management and follow along with all of the investments that I'm taking inside of this next bull run. I highly recommend that you guys check those out. All you have to do to get access or to message me to get more information is click the invitation link in the description of this video, and there you're going to get access to my Discord server. Once you have access to my Discord server, all you have to do is leave me a message and I will get back to you guys as soon as possible. With all that being said, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate each and every one of you killing it with the support. I do appreciate all of the positivity inside of my community and Discord server. So thank you guys so much. With all that being said, I will catch you in the next video. As always, peace out.